considered filling your water bottle in your washroom? Have you ever imagined drinking unfiltered water in this present environmental scenario? Isn't it scary? World Health Organization reports that there are 3.4 million people dying because of waterborne diseases annually. If you think that this is bad, then the situation in countless villages of our country is even worse. The worst part is that a lot of the details go unreported. This is the water situation in one among the many villages we visited. Poor sanitation is another problem which hits more than half of the world's poor at some point of time. In order to address these problems to some extent, the 100-100 project was undertaken. The main agenda of this project is to provide proper water facility to 100 villages using solar power. With the help of some local NGO bodies, 100 villages known to have bad water conditions are selected. The entire project is divided into four phases. Firstly, water tanks are built and then water pipes are laid to all the houses from the tank, followed by drilling the rig bores for underground water. By the time the process of building tanks, laying pipes and drilling rig bore is completed, solar panels, DC water pump from ground force and other accessories are dispatched to the respective villages for the next process of the project. Installation teams from Sunlit Future, with the help of local NGOs and villagers, start the installation of the solar panels, water pumps, wiring, etc. The designs are made beforehand based on the water requirement of the village. Installations are done based on those designs in each of these villages. Teams of three or four are dispatched in each area on each of the days to carry forward the installation process. At the same time, volunteers from the local NGOs are also trained to do the installation. After the installation, one of the villagers is appointed as the person in charge of the system. This appointed volunteer takes care of any further maintenance when necessary. Each of these villages have decided through internal discussions to pool a small amount of money from each household on a monthly basis and save them in the bank for future use in case the maintenance of the system is required.
Actually, what they are telling is they have three tubewells here in this village, but only two tubewells are giving water. The third one is not giving water. That is why they are only using the two tubewells. So that is the problem. And in the two wells what they are using, in the summer season particularly, the water dries up and dirty water is coming through that tubewell. So they have to filter it with a cloth, then only they are using. And they don't have any alternative, so they are forced to use that water only. That woman is telling that by using this boring this borewell and lifting water through the solar devices, and they will be able to get enough water for their latrines. So they have latrines in their village, they have constructed the latrines, but they do not have sufficient water in the latrines. So that is why many of the people, they are the particularly the women, they are reluctant to use the latrines. So now they are thinking that they will be able to get sufficient water in their latrines and everybody will be using those latrines.
Side of the wall of Pani Jibo Subida, City Pani Joma, Stock Notivo, or Skartivo, Sita Tikisubida.
Her name is Lalita Beura, and previously for washing clothes, they have to go to the Nala or to the well. But now, after getting the water here just near to their house, now she is happy that she is able to wash her clothes and the clothes of the entire family just here. and she's having enough water for that. And previously in the summer season they were facing many much problem because they have to travel a long distance to a nala.
They have resolved in their meeting that for the maintenance of this property they have formed a committee and they have selected one person to operate the machines. He will switch it off and switch it on every day.
They have hold a meeting so how they will manage this water system, but they have not yet decided how much they will be collecting. But she doesn't know. But some other members are telling that they will be collecting 30 rupees per month.